The imagination is the only limit here.
It's the most beautiful place in the world, and it's the most scary place in the world.
Love it, you hate it, you love it, you hate it. You don't want to be there, you want to be there.
Baja has a way of educating you. Push that edge, and you're done.
For generations, families have competed.
I lived it, I ate it, I slept it.
Challengers have tried to conquer.
You get off that line, it gets hairy.
The most dangerous race in the world.
This is an emergency, we have an injured driver.
The Baja 1000.
You don't fall asleep here.
The pressure of winning is always there.
You expect it.
Anything less, unacceptable.
As you go through life, if you knew you were making history, you would have paid more attention to it.
It's like being in a 24-hour plane crash.
You never, never, never give up.
1,000 miles, 32 hours, hundreds of drivers, including Robby Gordon, Jimmy Vassar, Ricky Johnson, and Grand Marshal Mario Andretti. They will meet their greatest challenge to finish what they started.
Go through whatever you have to go through and getting there. Just getting there.
The racer most identified with the Baja 1000 is NASCAR driver Robby Gordon.
I mean, this is his world. It isn't in NASCAR. This is his, where he's at. And you can see everybody defer to him here.
Robby was just a kid, and I took him for a ride out of Saddleback in one of the Blazers, and I can remember seeing his helmet up here, and he just loved it.
Robby became Baja's boy wonder. He's gone on to make millions racing from Daytona to Indy, but he never forgets his roots.
I left Homestead on Sunday night and flew out of the hotel, forgot a commercial airliner, flew to L.A. Left at 5 a.m. to come down here pre-ran. We pre-ran Monday and Tuesday, did the whole course in 2 days.
He was a little cocky, you know, probably hurting me a lot of ways.
I know where everybody's at. I'm going to watch every car go by the wayside. The car's good enough that 75% is faster than everybody else.
You know, a lot of good race drivers are cocky.
Numbers are drawn for starting position. Robby got the last spot.
It's driving that fine line where you get off that line, it gets hairy. It gets really hairy. But it's fun. It's fun on that line.
You don't look at the bump, you just look at, you know, like a roar that you might come off this side and hit the other side. Off-road racing, that cars behind you come up and give them a little bump in the back, and they kind of move over because they know a faster vehicle's behind them. If they don't move out of the way,
you don't know fear until you look in the rear view and see Robby Gordon.
Got 10 on your tail.
Robby had gotten a flat, but his pit crew was unprepared, putting Robby at full tilt. He blazed through 30 miles on a flat tire and nearly being first place before finally getting a change.